Hello, and welcome to the evening session of August 28, 2018. We are steadily working on tanks still. This morning we ended up getting the spawns for both the game spawns and the initial spawns created for the arena generator and or the arena creator, and getting that implemented as far as data goes as well. So that was successful. Now we're going to work on, to start off with, I think we're just gonna do checks while loading arena. I think we'll start this in progress first, and then we'll get to that. So that's a server side issue. And yeah, that's not right anymore. So in the arena loader, that's what it's called, right? Still climb. The client's getting so damn big you can't even differentiate between the two. Oh, I also increased, I want to do a test of this real quick. See how far down, it's still only about 50. Yeah, so it's only those first 50 lines that you can actually see. Alright. So, in here. And the arena loader. If the data.title is block locations. Const has just because since we're doing it, thank you. const has, Jesus Christ. So, just when you think you've seen it all, I actually have to use my own. That looks like the center. Well, at least it's working. So I guess we'll go with that. So, I mean, again, it's like that'll be more robust over time, I suppose. That I fixed. Fixed that a while back. Okay, I'll hide this one. Yeah, I'm. Decently passionate about that load message box for some reason. So I think I'm going to do that next. So essentially what that's going to be is a, so in I guess in any menu, it doesn't really have to be anywhere, because it's just an overlay where essentially where my mouse cursor is, there will be a big or not necessarily a big, but an overlay that will display text for a specified amount of time, and it'll fade in and out. So and the idea for this thing is just so that way we can relay data to the player just in a quick and dirty fashion, so to speak. So we'll move on to that. And you know, you almost want to call it a controller or something like that. I don't know. Because you got your camera, you got your controllers. I don't know. So, anyway. Just trying to think through this here. Well, the first thing we're going to need, obviously, is an actual alerts div of sorts. I think that's really all we need. It's pretty much all going to be styled from there. So I don't know. I think we can get away with it. Just import. I don't know. I guess we'll see. Okay, so I guess we get somewhere. So sorry, can't see it. There it is. Load message request. The reason why we're doing it that way is so that, because we're just going to enable a damn thing and then just let it do its own thing. I don't think I'm gonna bother with that. I think we'll just keep it as a message. And then just let the client handle how long the message will stay up. It's nice. Message fixed. Are you kidding me? Oh, oops. What message? That stuff top. 15%. That, it's not gonna fix it, but well, it is, but oh, we oh, what the fuck? Okay, I see what's going on here. I don't actually think it needs that, I think it just needs this. Oh, it does. I've never had that happen. I don't know what the fuck is going on. You can lose 100%. Oh, and you have that. And then your display is inline block. Well, how'd I get the thing? So what is going on with this? Game. Thank you. Is that so difficult? This dot parent. Thank you. That's good. Loop request. Is equal to 1. This dot task ID is equal to. I don't know if they start off at 0 or 1 and I'm not taking a chance. For now, just 3 seconds. Set timeout and 3 seconds. This dot parent element dot and then this if, so if the task ID is equal to -1, then we're doing this because there's nothing running. Otherwise, clear timeout of this.task ID, and then this.task ID is equal to, oops. Text content is equal to message, and then we can do this. So that should be good. Yeah, because that thing's always there. So we can save this. Hello. And then in the HTML, can lose this. I just want to refresh the page and see what it looks like. It's just top of it now. Oh, I gotcha. I know what's going on here. So then in the alert message, we don't actually want to set the text content. We actually want to. Honestly, we can leave it. It's like I don't like the idea of that, and eventually I think that will be something. Well, I mean, if this thing even sticks around. Yeah, that's better. Okay. Like, obviously it's still there, but it's just not worth it. Sad day. Send alert. Must be what's going on. Okay. Idiot. Let data. Okay. On the packet receiver on this end. receive alert. So that should be it on the front end. That should receive it. So now we're really looking at potentially the match rotator. So start preparing. So we send them the game status, and then players sub I dot send alert match. Yeah. Okay. So I don't really know if that's helpful, but get the fuck out of here. Yeah, that's exactly what's going on. I was wondering, like, what the hell? Okay. So that's that. So alert messages are working anyway, so that's a good step. So I can archive that, that's done. Create a loop for you. So. Honestly, I think I'm gonna call it quits for this evening, even though we flew under an hour. The next thing I want to work on, though, is now that we're in the arena, I want to actually get a block in here that resembles a tank, just a different colored block of a slightly different size, a slightly oblong shape, most likely, so that way, and then work on getting movement controls on the server side for that, because right now I'm like, the stuff I have on the board, like, it's all important, yeah, but like the next thing is moving forward with the game, and that involves getting a tank in the world that you can follow. So I think that's what we'll do tomorrow morning. So for now, I think that's it, though. So thanks for stopping by, and we'll see you next time.